Hello and welcome to the 13th part of my LEGO Port Up tutorial that you can use for Port Up, LEGO Boost and Control Plus. Today we will take a look again at the campfire and at the lamps in the wilderness that we used in the last part, and I have the same setting, at least essentially. I changed a few things because I recorded the last part a few days ago, but I still use the same lamps and they're at the same positions. Anyways, this was the program in the last part. And in the last part, we had the problem that the fire is very flickery, that it changes very much between or very fast between very dark and very bright. And we wanted to have a way to remember the last value so that we can have slighter steps between dark and light. And for that, we will discover a new thing in programming, and that's variables. We have two blocks for variables. We have four if we go to the complete list, but these two will be enough for now. And we can use them to store values and to remember values. So we have maybe a sheet of paper. We can write a number to the paper, and then we can read the number again. We can write a new number to the paper, and then we can read the new number. That's how variables work. And they have a name, so that we know how to address them. And they have a value. That's the second part. So we can use this block to write to the variable, and this block to read the variable. They are very powerful and very advanced programming, and you can do much, much stuff with it. I myself needed a long time to understand the true potential of variables, so we will make a few steps, or one step at a time. You should try them out on your own as well, and try to understand them and try to maybe see how, what you can do with them, because they are very powerful. And normally we give the variable a value at the beginning of the program so that we know what value it has before we change the value or before we read the value. So let's put this block to the beginning of the program and let's figure out a good starting value. Basically, the minimum value of the light is 0 and the maximum value is 100. We can put the variable to something in between. So we could select 0, we could select 100. But maybe, or I think that it's smart to start in the middle between them so that it has the same possibility to go up as it has to go down. So let's use the number 50. Oh, and by the way, I won't change the hub light because that's pretty dark anyways. I will only care for these two LEDs in this program. So we have the variable that stores the light of the lamp, and we have the lamps or the blocks to control the lamps. Currently they have random values, but we have a value that stores the amount of light that should shine in the program. So let's take an actual number, or let's use this variable as input for the light. So now we can change the value of the variable in the program. We can calculate with a variable and so on, and we can use the value that we can change within the program, that we can control in the program, to change the light or to change the brightness of the lights. And you can do that for all sorts of blocks. You can do that for motors, for lights, for sliders, basically for everything. So we have a variable and we have lamps that shine with the light of the variables, but we want to change the variable itself. So we want it to flicker, and now we can think about how we could let it flicker. I'm pretty sure that there are many people that wrote many discussions about that. Maybe the model building community has its own ways. Maybe you can find good ways to flicker there. I will use a very basic attempt, and I will add or subtract 15 of the variable in each loop round. it will add 15 to the variable, or it will subtract 15 from the variable, or it will do nothing. It still flickers, and we can change how fast it flickers if we change the amount that it changes with each turn, but it still stays pretty close to the actual variable, and it will change for a maximum of 15 in each run. So we want to read the variable, and we want to give it a new value. And we want to have some kind of math between this block and this block to change the value of the variable. And we want to either add 15 or subtract 15 to the variable, so we can use the plus block to add stuff. And we want the result to go into the variable. Another question is, how do we make a number, a random number, that is between, or that has the numbers minus 15, 0, or 15? It's kind of the same logic as the motors that have a negative value to turn into a different direction. So we can have a random number, but yet now it would have all numbers between 1 and 10, but we want to have three discrete values, minus 15, 0, and 15. So I will let it change between minus 1 and 1. So it will be minus 1, 0, or 1, this output. But we want it to be minus 15, 0, or 15. So you can think about how to make minus 15 or 15 or 0 from minus 1, 1, or 0. I hope that you did that. You can pause the video if you haven't done it already. And the result or the solution is to multiply the output with 15. So now we will add 15, minus 15, or 0 to the variable in each turn. And I will add this block to the program, the output of the variable, so that we can check the output while the program runs. So let's start the program. And I will switch to the webcam. So let's start it. And we can see that the light flickers. The value changes between numbers, but now it got below 1 or below 0. And that can happen currently. We can get to values below 0 or above 100 that we don't want, because the light can't be brighter than 100 and can't be less bright than 0. So we kind of have to catch values that don't fit into our math. And there's a way to do that, but we will check that out in the next part. So thanks for watching for this part. You can already think about how you would do it on your own. Keep in mind to play a bit with variables and to try to understand them. Thanks for watching. See you in the next part, and bye.